creek, stream, whatever you want to call it. See how fine that material is? And I mean, this is material. If you had a gold pan full of material and you started to pan and you started to stratify, by the third swirl, this stuff is long since gone. So it's very, very, very hard to assay it when you're only using 30, 40 grams of material. But the enrichment process is very, very fast. It's not as slow as you'd think. So let's get off some of this excess material, and I'll just roll with what I've built up in the pan. Mm-hmm. Let's get it moving. Let's get this stuff moving. Now, fine gold needs lots and lots and lots and lots and lots of friends. We really need this shit clear. You know what? Let me redo this, because I got... Well, it's not too bad. It's still kind of gritty. Let me see if I can get up one of them boulders. You see that sand there? Mm-hmm. That, for what we're talking about right now, that's boulders. So let's go about this at a different direction. Let me take this other pan here. Let's get this material here lifted up and into solution. Make sure this pan is cleaned out a little bit. Don't want anyone to say I salted my pan. All right. Good enough for this. Let's get this material moving. Let's get it up now. Let's get rid of that sand. Right now, like an idea, I want to make sure I don't want no more big stuff in there. All I want is that sediment, that particulate, that is suspended in solution right now. Good God, Ray, look at all that mica. There's still a lot of gold in that. I'm going to have to pan that down after. Okay, let's try this again. Now that we know we have no super, super huge pieces and boulders. There, you see how fast that material drops? Now we've got that dead band forming already. The more surface area that you can provide gold, the better. That's what it takes, is just surface area. I did there was a guy asking a question about fine gold on one of the forums. And I suggested to him that he make a 40-foot long tom. And everyone was thinking that I was actually suggesting that as a recovery method to him. What it was the point of playing with the material. Because in that length of a Henry, all your material is going to settle out. You're basically going to be pushing clean water at the end. Because all your material will have a chance to settle out. Now you might have to play with the angles a little bit. You know, nothing in mining is plug and play. That's the first thing people have to understand. Nothing in mining is plug and play. Nothing at all. Now let's start bringing it back. Now that is some ultra. I don't know if this bloody camera's gonna catch it. Let's take it back to show what we're actually pushing here. There's my line. See how ultra fine that is? That's wild stuff. I love it. This is the stuff here that hard rock miners love. Yes, I am losing gold, but we're speeding this up in order to do this damn video. Ray. How did that get in there, buddy?
Vienna?
Hmm?
Vienna?
Oh, it's probably from the pan. It's probably tucked into the pan. That's what that is. Let's get all this material in one spot. No, you would never use this as a recovery method, but it is a very effective sampling tool. Very effective. Especially if you're checking a gold baron system. That is the end-all be-alls, the silts and the clays. That will tell you almost the whole life story of that canyon. Bigger gold that you find in places like that has normally been deposited by a glacier, a paleoplacer deposit. That in itself is a whole other science. Very few people realize actually how much there is to mining. There is science after science. You know, you see all that fine mica and stuff right in the top? Mm-hmm. A little bit of copper. We're actually going to be able to pan that out. Because most of my gold is down at the bottom. Now, if I was to stop here and take this material and run it again, I could get that classification even finer. Even finer. Let's get all that little crud off the top. Let's bring her back a bit, because yes, I'm losing gold. But you see how fine that material is that we're panning. And I say that is about 149 micron. Let's get rid of all the crap. There is no speed panning this. I gotta rinse out that corner there too. You could find a canyon that looks completely barren of gold and be one of the richest lodes that you'll ever come across in your life. But no one hardly ever checks for this. The hard rock guys do. Because this is something what they're hunting for. This is a lot of that gold you ain't gonna see, to put it in layman's terms. Let's get rid of some crap now. We can move a little bit. I'll have to take this back later and put it under the microscope. Look at that. Woohoo! Heavy stuff. See, and if I want to drop it out, let it roll across the pan, use that surface area of the bottom of the pan, and then draw it back. And then I can start swishing it into place. Look how fine that is.
Bring it to you.
A lot of fine gold is different, has lots of different things mixed in it. This ultra-fine gold mixed with quartz, woo, problematic. There are other things to use for enrichment. Other methods. Mm-hmm. Now you got to remember, we're just panning the float off pan. We are just panning the float off a pan. Look at that. And obviously a contaminated pan. But the point still being that we are actually gathering that material. And that is finer than face powder. That is the ultimate in small material. So let me finish it out. And I'll pan down that other one real quick. Now, at this point right here, if I was really trying to bulk it up, right here is where I would stop. I wouldn't go any further than how much I have in this pan. And I want to add to it. The more little gold friends that I can provide it, the easier it's going to bulk up, the faster it's going to bulk up, and the easier it's going to be to pan. Gets that hard, nice hard base in there. Mm-hmm. That is exactly it. That can go. Let's roll this back a little bit. You see how heavy that material is?
Mm-hmm.
See how fast it drops? Well, that is some, as I say, about 149 micron. There it is. Look at that. Look at that. We got something else with it too. We're gonna have to grab the loop, take a look. Be really interesting to see under the microscope. See what we've got riding with it. Looks like a little bit of white quartz. When you get this small, gets interesting. All right. Here we go. Let's actually take a look. Let's roll her on back in the pan. Let's actually take a look. Look at that. See, so on that ultra fine ray, the stuff you have is not that bad, but it's still not as hot as that other material. See how fine that is? Let me get it to float. Woohoo! Check that out. Okay?
That being your goal.
That being your goal.